Hey y'all, it's Lorray Renee, your host. Thoughts of the Blog Queen podcast is what you are tuned into right now. I appreciate you guys for clicking play and spending this time with me. Before I go any further, you guys know the routine. If you aren't already following me on Instagram, make sure you head over there and click that follow button. Thoughts of the Blog Queen _ podcast. And make sure you support me on my other platform, which is Pink Tea Chronicles _ podcast. You guys, it's been a few weeks since I've been on the mic, and hopefully you guys missed me because I definitely missed you guys. But I had some personal things going on. It wasn't anything bad. It was actually good things, but I really just wanted to take some time out to be in that moment of my life. And so I just decided to put a halt on everything for the time being. But here I am, and you guys know this current series is a 5-part series, and I'm wrapping it up. I am recording this on a Saturday, actually, and I'm dropping it tonight, and we are going to be done with What a Woman Wants. We had a lot of shit to talk about, right? It's a lot of shit that we want, but it was simple things, right? But I just wanted to take this time out to express all of the things that I think all of my ladies could agree with on what it is that we want in a healthy relationship. So make sure that you guys tune into this episode, and make sure you guys tune into part 5. And actually, at the end of part 5, I'm going to talk about some other things. And also, I'm going to talk about the listener's lotto. You guys, that is still a thing. That is still going on. We are still getting with it. I am still giving away some cash to a loyal supporter of the show. So you definitely need to go back and you need to listen to go ahead and do a binge. Listen to all of the episodes in this series. There are 5. And they're not very long. They're not very long at all. So catch up, because I want somebody to get that cash, and I'm not playing. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get into, what are we doing this episode? We're doing P through T. So if you're tuning into this for the first time, then you definitely need to go back, because what I did was I talked about all of the things that a woman wants in a good relationship, right? Like a healthy relationship. And so I did that, but I did a little fun kick on it, and I'm doing it as the alphabet. So we're going through the alphabets. And again, like I said, we're going to do P through T. So, before we get started, go ahead, grab something, a snack, a drink. I don't know. Get whatever you need, and let's podcast and chill.
Let's do this.
It's showtime.
You're listening to the Thoughts of a Blog Queen podcast.
These are just my thoughts.
With your host, Lorray Renee.
A woman, her thoughts, and a mic.
Are you ready? Check this out.
All right, y'all. Did you get what you needed? Did you get your water, your wine, your liquor, your Henny, your Coke, your snack, whatever it is that you needed? Get that. And just vibe with me on this, because I do this for the ladies. I do this for my sisters. Everything that I do is for my sisters. And so I thought it would be really cool to break down a list of all of the things that we want and that we need in our relationships. And so let's go ahead and get this thing started. We're talking about P, protection. We want protection. And when I say we want protection, I mean that physically, and I mean that emotionally too, right? So protection, we definitely want a man that is going to be able to, you know, just, you got us, take care of us. You know, we're good. You know, we don't have to worry about anything. You know, we need that strong. We want that strong man, right? But when I say protection as far as emotions, like, I want you to protect my heart. I want you to take care of my heart the same way that you want me to take care of your heart, right? Because it's a valuable thing. And if I'm giving that to you, and if I'm putting that emotion into our relationship, protect it. Don't do anything to jeopardize what we have. Protect our relationship, protect my heart, and you will definitely be able to reap the benefits of doing that. You will be able to see just how appreciative we are of that, because that is something that we look for, that is something that we need, and that is something that you're going to get back. It's about reciprocity, right? You want to get what you're giving, and vice versa, and all that good stuff. So that's what we need when it comes down to protection, right? All right, let's move on. And you guys, I'm not gonna draw this out because we have two episodes to do. So I'm gonna kind of fly through this one. So if I'm talking a little fast, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna try to get through this as swiftly as possible so we can move on. All right, Q, what do we want? We want quality time. Quality time. And actually, that is a love language as well. And so for some people, that is exactly what they need from you in order to be able to correlate the fact that you actually love. That is how they receive love, through quality time. That's actually what I would say would be my secondary love language. My first love language is words of affirmation, but my secondary one, I think, would have to be quality time. And we want that special time with you guys. We want to feel like, you know, out of everything that is going on in my life, everything that is going on in your life, we still make time for quality time. And quality time and just cohabitating in the same space, that is two totally different things, because you can live with a person, right? You can definitely live with a person and not have quality time. And I think some people forget that. You get comfortable because you think, well, we're under the same roof. I see her every day. So isn't that quality time enough? And no, it is not. There needs to be special, carved out quality time in a good, healthy relationship, right? So, moving along, R, respect, right? That's a given. We want respect. And that can be broken down into so many different ways, right? We want respect when you are around us. Like, I want you to give me the respect that I deserve as a woman, as a queen, as your queen. But I also want that respect when you are not around. Like, have some sort of respect for me when we're apart. Learn, you know how to carry yourself when you are in a relationship, because, you know, I think, you know, men that aren't capable and don't have the capacity to give a person what they need in a healthy relationship. Again, we're talking about healthy relationships, not just any kind of relationship. I think that they are, sometimes they forget the respect of when they are not around their woman, and they think, you know, what she don't know don't hurt her, or what she, you know, don't see, she don't, you know, she don't know, you know, she'll be all right. And that is so far from the truth. So respect. I want you to respect me in front of and behind my back. Period. Right? I mean, I don't even really have to, like, elaborate on that. That's just is what it is. Respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. all right, moving on, you guys. So for S, standards, and I have an extra one, simplicity. So for standards, yes, and that actually kind of connects with what I just said. Standards. We want standards in your relationship. And what I mean by that is, know how to carry yourself when we are not together. But have standards for yourself. Like, don't put yourself in situations that you know are going to taint our relationship. Don't put yourself in situations with your homeboys or whoever it may be, or even if you're not with your homeboys, but just don't put yourself in situations where you're going to fuck up what we have. Right. And also, when I say standards, I definitely mean that, understand that I have standards and I need you to respect those standards. I have standards for who I am sharing my life with. I have standards for who I am in a relationship with. I have standards for who I'm deciding to be intimate with. All of that is with you. And so know that by that, there are things that I expect of you. It's just like I know that there are things that you expect of me as your woman. It's a two-way street, right? I'm not just saying that women have to have all these standards and then they can just, you know, do whatever the hell that they want. No, I'm not co-signing that. I'm saying, you know, we both need to have standards. But speaking for a woman, understand that I have standards and that I have expectations of this relationship. And, you know, maybe, you know, and that's why it's very important to get out everything that you need to get out in the very beginning, of the relationship. Put all your cards out on the table and talk about, have those hard discussions early on. Make sure you guys are on the same page, because that's where you can really waste a lot of time in your life and a lot of your energy when you don't talk about those types of things just from the beginning. So make sure that is something that you are doing. Right? All right, moving on. Oh, and I said I had an extra one. I had simplicity. And what I mean by simplicity in a relationship, I mean that we want the simple things. Y'all remember that song Miguel had about, it was called Simple Things, if I'm not mistaken. And it was basically just talking about how a woman just wants those simple little pleasures in the relationship. We want you to just, it's the smallest of things, and that could be even in, you know, we just talked about quality time. That could be in you know, involved in the quality time, the simple things. I just want you to be considerate of me and just do, you know, think about me and do things that you know would mean a lot to me. And it doesn't have to be anything that is financial. It doesn't have to be anything that costs a dime. Understand that when I say simple things, I literally mean simple things that you know will make my life easier. Do those things. Do those things for her, fellas, if you're listening to this right now. Do those things for her that you know she will appreciate. Don't ever take those small things for granted. We love that shit. We need it and we want it. And that's, it's a small thing, but it's a big thing. It means a lot. And I'm telling you right now, the more that you do when it comes to that aspect of the relationship, oh, you will be rewarded. You will be rewarded. So think about those things, those simple little things that you know she's going to appreciate. Take the time to do those things, whatever they may be. You know your woman, right? You know your woman. If it's a serious relationship and you know her, you know what she's going to appreciate. Do those things. And I'm telling you, you're going to be good. All right. So moving along, what are we doing now? We are talking about trust. That's the letter T, trust, right? You guys should have known that I was going to talk about trust and that was going to be on the list. We want trust. And we want trust on so many different levels. I want to be able to trust you in every aspect of my life. Not just trust in a way where I know that you're not going to cheat on me. You're not going to do anything behind my back with another woman. But I want to be able to trust you in all areas of my life. Now, for me, I'm a mother, right? So my son, my child is a major part of my life. And so I want to be able to trust you around my child. I want to be able to know that you have the best of your, you know, the best of interest in for him as well. I want to be able to trust that I can talk to you about certain things that are going on with me. I need to be able to confide in you. I'm pretty sure I talked about friendship at some point on the list. And so that is kind of connected to trust too. I want to be able to talk to you and confide in you in about certain things. And I want to know that it's okay to do that with you. And I know that it stays with you, and that the things that are going on within our relationship, I really feel like, you know, there are just certain things that go on in the relationship that you just don't need to share with other people. You don't need to talk about that with your homeboy. You don't need to talk about that with your mom. You don't need to talk about it with your sister. You don't need to talk about it with your brother. Like, there are just certain things, you know, just really need to stay between the two of you. And I want to trust that you, because after I express that to you, like for me, that's one of the things that I make sure that I express in my relationship. And so, and it's important to me. It's important to me that we keep the sacredness of things that happen in our relationship, and that we aren't out there talking about all of our problems that we have and all of the things that go on. Because listen, once you put it out there, you can't unsay it. It's out there for whoever it is that you tell it to. And so protect it. Oh, see, we're back at protection. Protect the things that happen within your relationship and keep them there. But I want to make sure that I can trust you to do that and know that it is an important, it's important for me to do that, right? It's important for me to be able to say to you, well, babe, you know, this is like, this is important, and this is what's going on, or this is what we, you know, this is what's happening, whatever it may be. It may not even be a relationship problem. It could be something else. You know what I mean? Like, these things that I'm going over, they can definitely be applied in different ways. So take what you need, leave what you don't, but I just want to be able to trust that we have an understanding on all levels of our relationship. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, that trust is important. And then of course the obvious one, yeah, I want to make sure that I can trust you not to fuck up. I want to make sure that I can trust you not to be out there doing what, you know, dogging me out and being disrespectful to me and cheating and doing shit you don't have any business doing. I want to make sure that I can sleep at night and know that I don't have to worry about you. Because when I begin to lose sleep because of my relationship, oh, we have a problem. We have a big problem. You shouldn't have to lose sleep. Because for one, you shouldn't have to go to bed feeling a certain type of way. You shouldn't have to go to bed hurt or angry or upset. You should be able to talk to your person and you guys get those types of things, you know, out there, right? But I want to be able to trust that it's what's going on between us is just with us. It's not for everybody to know. You know, I know we have our best friend or, you know, our parent or whoever it is that we confide in, that we vent to and then we talk to. But I'm telling you, like, I just feel like the older we get, I feel like you begin to realize that there has to be a boundary. There has to be a line for what it is that you share. Because you know, how you choose to move forward in your relationship, that is a choice that you have to make. And you don't need the outsiders, people outside of your relationship, to comment on that, to side-eyeing you about decisions that you made after you done put all your business out there and you done told everybody in the family at Thanksgiving over when the women was talking in the kitchen. You done spilled all the dirt, all the tea. And then you still choose to continue in your relationship, or you choose to forgive, or you choose, or you did it, or whatever. And then people, you know, have something to say, or they're thinking things in the back of their mind. Not that you should really care what other people think, but to an extent, I guess maybe you should. But I say all that to say, protect your relationship and keep things between the two of you, right? There's only two people in the relationship. So keep that guard around the two of you and everything that you guys have going on, and make a decision. If you have a problem, or if you have an issue or a situation going on in your relationship, talk about it first. I know that, you know, in my relationship there, you know, we've had situations where, you know, we agreed that we wanted to have, like, my mom give her opinion or hear out the situation, whatever it may have been. We agreed upon that. And so if that's something that you're doing, that's fine. If that's how you handle that. But agree on it first. Don't just go running and, you know, and just be on the same page. That's where that trust comes in. That's where that protection comes in. That's where that communication that I know I talked about comes in, right? So yeah, so that's it. So P through T. So let's run them back, you guys. So we have protection. We had quality time. We had respect. We had standards. And I gave you a bonus one, simplicity. And we have trust. Those are the things that we want in our relationship. Our good relationships. Our healthy relationships. Our non-toxic ass relationships. Those are the things that we desire. All right. So I am just hitting the 20 minute mark, which is exactly where I wanted to be for this episode. So you guys, I'm gonna wrap it up here. Make sure you guys go and tune in to part 5. Don't go anywhere just yet, you guys. Go ahead and let the next episode play. And let's wrap up the rest of this series. We're going to knock out U through Z and finish up this What a Woman Wants. So thank you guys for tuning in. Don't go anywhere. You guys go refill up your cups. Go get some more snacks. And meet me right back here. All right, you guys. Peace.
Let's do this.
It's showtime.
You're listening to the Thoughts of a Blog Queen podcast.
These are just my thoughts.
With your host, LaRae Renee.
A woman, her thoughts, and a mic.
Are you ready? Check this out.